Hi, I'd like to welcome you to my video on how I make gold in SMCath. It's a 6-minute run. This is basically what I have been doing for a while. It's a power level where I basically get all the good loot and they get all the great experience. What's happening here is I've made a macro to target the pile of corpses because I do want them to not spawn zombies over and over because we are pulling these two Pandarens through the instance. Once in a while, I may have to drop a consecration to get the attention of the mob since they're still fighting each other. Here, I focus just on the boss. You'll see one of the monks already dinged. Now, here you're going to see me use my Speed of Light, which is a new ability which increases my run speed by 70%. I'm going to keep the rest of this video in regular speed just so you guys can get a feel for how often I get stunned and everything else. Boosting ahead gives me a little bit of a chance to, focus on the newer mobs. I lay a consecration back here just to remind the mobs that are chasing me that I'm still there. The Scarlet Purifiers throughout this use a AoE Flame Strike or Purifying Flames, which basically is this flame tower that gets cast right on you. The Zealots will actually they use Smite and heal the allies. They also, when they die, the Spirit of Redemption appears. The fanatics, which look like the monks, have like that punch, which is like that air punch, and they also have their hands basically get a fire buff. Now, if you focus your attention in the bottom left-hand corner again, you'll notice the monks actually pull some aggro on a couple of the spirits. They start running away. The best thing to do is to actually run towards the paladin, not away. So, we're in vent. I'm like, run towards me. I run back. I'm going to drop a consecration there so that I help peel these mobs off them or kill them. And in doing so, you're going to see that one of them does level to level 31, which would have been a little better when we rounded them all up, but congrats. The other mobs you're going to see here are the Scarlet Judicators, which are a two-hand melee class. Once in a while, they'll do this big slice down. As we move up, we're going to move on to Brother Korloff, that when he dies, he's going to open the door. You'll see him spinning around doing the Firestorm kick. After this, he's going to cast his Blazing Fist. If you do get him down to around half health, he's going to cast, fire on the ground that you don't stand in. And then, of course, he's the one that you focus on to open the doors so that you can progress with your mass AoE pull. Right here, I pop my new ability called Clemency, which is going to refresh the cooldown on my Hand of Freedom so I can cast that again. Because as you see, I'm getting stunned like crazy. I can only cast Clemency every 5 minutes, so I at least want to use it once this run. See, here I try to single taunt, but I accidentally cast Avenger's Shield. I'm kind of playing blind a little bit. I actually use this G510 keyboard, and from my other videos, you guys know that everybody's like, your UI is a mess, but it makes sense visually to the way that the keys are laid out. And because this is beta and I can't lay it out that way, it's a little bit more difficult. So here's that other boss, which we single target down. It opens up the door. I get stunned here, and rather than running to get the final mobs, I'm just going to cast a little AoE consecration to get them. It saves me from running there, running back, because the big thing is stunning. I'm popping my racial, I'm popping my Hand of Freedom whenever I can, and also that new running ability, which is rocking because it provides distance so that I don't get stunned. Actually, I'll pop it here again. You'll see. It's really neat to watch it in the bottom left-hand corner too, just to see the mobs trail in behind. As I'm in there, they're still chasing after me. And the two monks that are actually helping out, they've got their own channels, which I'll have linked at the end. The other thing too is all these casters, they're initiates. They do basically the same thing where they heal and smite, but they don't cast that little Spirit of Redemption when they die. Then when we move to Commander Durand, he's basically a melee character that once in a while will do this dashing strike, which is pretty awesome to watch. And of course, when he dies, out comes White Mane. And White Mane, she uses Holy Smite, some heals. She does cast Mass Resurrection. And what's really weird is the Adjudicators, they actually aggro to you when she casts that if you don't interrupt it. As you see in the bottom right-hand corner, I'm just going through the abilities so that you guys can see it all meshed together. The one thing that I didn't cover was, because I covered it in my last graveyard video, was the guys with the tankards on the back. They're the ones that are doing all the fire damage throughout the pull. So now we got them all rounded up. So now it's go time, where I'm popping everything. You'll see that the two pandas are getting aggro from the boss. Like, I mean, this boss aggro's far. I'm letting them know that they can actually heal themselves now. I've said don't heal through the entire thing because you don't want to pull aggro. But by this point, I should have enough aggro that a level 29 and 31 won't actually pull off me. Hopefully. Now, but of course, I'm sitting in here in the room of death, and White Mane comes out and she's focused on one of them. So I pull aggro and it's game over. I've got a few videos out, guys. The video on the top left-hand corner, that's actually Munchie's first video, which I'm actually in. If you want to see me run them through Dead Mines, and it's our vent conversation, he's got part 1 and 2. I'll have a link there. If you missed my video at the beginning of April on how to meet friends once you're in the beta, it's a very great video with lots of people. Thank you to everybody. If you guys watch the other people that were in that video, make sure you send them a message on their latest video saying Hob says thank you for being in the how to meet friends. Thanks again, guys. Make sure you subscribe so you'll be the first to know when my next video is out. As long as you keep watching, I'll keep making them.